I'm 3D Luke, and this is my hockey product. I've combined my love of 3D printing, hockey, and creating, so I designed a hockey training product that can be used at all levels. The product design is simple, but I underestimated the behind-the-scenes work this would actually take to complete at a level I'd feel comfortable selling. So I'm going to document this journey of completing the project. I designed iteration after iteration, improving the product as I test it myself. When I last left off, I was able to narrow down specific materials and an added feature that will take this project to the next level. Originally, we started with a piece that did not move when it was hit, but it was apparent that I should add a hinge to the design. I found a print-in-place hinge and added it to the design. I made the product out of 4 different materials and even tried different clamp designs in order to see which design would hold to the post best. It's obvious the design needs to be beefed up, so we're adding a metal hinge, and I'm excited about this because I think it'll make the future designs easier to create. And it's also adding a feature of self-resetting, so this product will be even more useful as the hinge allows the panel to pop back into place after it is hit. So now we have the idea in our head. It's time to create the next iteration and put together our new design.
This is the long-term plan. This is essentially the roadmap for this entire project. And right now, we're focused on developing a functional prototype, which means we want to be able to hold it in our hand, but we're not necessarily concerned with making sure all the materials are correct right now. We'll get to the strength of materials once the functional prototype has been proven. This is how I envision the product to look. The hinge will be hugging the post, and there will be a small gap between the panel and the clasp. We know from previous tests which clasp we want to use to hug the post, and the panel has gotten even simpler. We don't even need to 3D print panels, we just need to find metal panels that we can drill holes into the hinge. As this is coming together, I have a few current worries. The hinge tension being too high, I'm worried that the panel won't have enough give when it's hit, so it might lead to a dented panel, the device popping off the post, or the puck deflecting back at the shooter. I'm also concerned about hinge placement, because the better the hinge is nestled into the clamp, the more secure the entire device will be. So I want to get the measurements extremely precise to give this thing its best chance of holding up when I test it. So I'm using an app to scan the hinge. That will give me an object that I can make cuts out of in the CAD software. The mesh that was created is a lot bumpier than I anticipated, but for what I need it for, it should suffice. I'm using this object to create a cutout of the hinge scan within the clamp in order to create a cavity for the hinge to nestle into. We can always circle back later to create a more flush cutout, but I'm hoping this will be enough. I'm having trouble with file formats and rendering shapes from the mesh in FreeCAD, so I cleaned up the object in Prusa Slicer and will create the clamp in FreeCAD, import it into Prusa Slicer, subtract the hinge object from the clamp, and finally, we will have the clamp for this iteration and we can get to printing. So, it's the next morning. The piece took 4 hours and 14 minutes to print, and it took 88 cents of filament. And I'm happy with how it turned out. I sanded the piece a little and added the hinge, which fit perfectly. It also gave me the idea to make the device modular so you could switch targets super easily, but that'll be figured out in a future video. Now it's time to attach the panel. So we headed to Home Depot and got a bunch of different types of metal. They didn't have exactly what I was looking for, however, I could buy multiple sheets and stack them, and this should work. The only issue with the thicker piece of metal is that the screw holes don't really line up, so we'll deal with that another time, but for now we'll go with the thinner pieces of metal and see how that works. The panel is a bit off center, but that doesn't mess with the functionality. Once we nail that down, we can come back and make sure all of the materials are perfect. So here we go, let's put it together. Spectacular. It is everything I wanted and more. I'm extremely excited to test this out. I do notice that the metal panels are very heavy. I'm not concerned that the device will stick to the posts. I am worried it may come off the post whenever it's hit. So I do have a few things I want to focus on next video when I go out and test the product for real. But specific things I want to change is not having multiple panels, rather a thicker panel that lines up better with all 3 hinge holes. I want to improve the hinge cavity. I want the hinge to set in the hinge cavity a little further and be more secure. And I want to put grip tape inside the clamp
to fully fasten it to the post. So when the panel is hit, the device doesn't move at all off the post. It only moves as intended. So the plan is to test the device after I print a few more. That will come in the next video. I need any sort of idea or potential worries that you might see, so feel free to leave a comment. And next video, not only will we go out on the ice and test the product you just saw me make, but we're going to add improvements to the current design. Thank you so much for watching, and please leave a like and subscribe. It helps me grow, and so you can be recommended the next video in the series. I'll be giving updates about this project, so again, please subscribe if you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching.